Hello and welcome to the episode 108 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. The first Beatles appearance at the Royal Albert Hall, the rehearsals for ITV's Around The Beatles, and a lengthy late recording session are some of the things on our menu today. On the 18th of April 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed at a top 10 club in Hamburg, West Germany. Their second residency was going strong, and the Beatles were filling the club every night. Third residency in 1962, the Beatles, still with Pete Best, were on the stage of the Star Club. 1963, the first appearance of the Beatles at the Royal Albert Hall in London. The concert, in two halves, was organized and partially broadcast by BBC Radio and featured Del Shannon, The Springfields, Lance Percival, Rolf Harris, The Vernon's Girls, Kenny Lynch, Shane Fenton and The Fentones, and George Melly, with the Fab Four topping the bill. The day started at 10:15 a.m. with the first rehearsal. Another rehearsal took place at 12:45 p.m. For the first part of the evening, a normal 8 to 8:50 p.m. concert that was not even recorded, the Beatles performed Please Please Me and Misery. The second part of the event, from 9:10 to 10:15 p.m., was broadcast live in United Kingdom and, from 9:15 to 10:00 p.m., across several nations abroad thanks to the BBC General Overseas Service. The foreign public missed the Beatles, though, because their performance started at 10:02 p.m., featuring Twist and Shout and From Me to You. The band had planned to perform Thank You Girl as the first song and rehearsed accordingly, but decided to change to the more lively Twist and Shout at the very last minute, without communicating the change even to the program producers. For the concert finale, the Beatles, along with all the other acts on the bill, performed an instrumental version of the 1928 Kurt Weill song Mack the Knife. After the event, Paul McCartney met his soon-to-be girlfriend Jane Asher for the first time. In the afternoon, the 17-year-old Jane had posed as a screaming Beatles fan for the BBC's Radio Times Weekly Journal. Moving on to 1964, we find the Beatles spending the morning at the Twickenham Film Studios. The task at hand was to add or re-record bits of dialogue for their A Hard Day's Night film. In the afternoon, the band reached the Hall of Remembrance in London to take part to the rehearsals for an ITV television special called Around the Beatles. The special, negotiated by the Beatles' manager Brian Epstein to further increase the exposure of the band, featured the lads and Cilla Black, Sons Incorporated, the American dance act The Jets, PJ Proby, The Vernon's Girls, Long John Baldry, and Millie. This was the first rehearsal for the Beatles, while the other acts had been involved since the 17th of April, some since the 13th. The pressing matter of completing their first feature film meant that they could only attend 3 of the 5 scheduled rehearsals. Fun fact, PJ Proby's band featured a young Jimmy Page on guitar. Another fact is that you can be instrumental in helping me to put together more music-related content of a higher quality. How? You can find out visiting www.simonmas.com/support. In brief, drop me a line voicing your opinion, talk about the podcast to your friends, and/or send me a small donation. Boy, send me a big one if you can. Show me how fab you are. Thank you! On the 18th of April 1965, between 10 a.m. and 12:30 p.m., 3 tentative mono mixes of Help and several stereo mixes of Help and The Night Before were made at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road. Only one of the mixes, the third mono mix of Help, will ever see any use. Specifically, it was included in the film of the same name. 1 year later, in 1966, John Lennon and George Harrison went out to the Marquee Club in London to watch The Loving Spoonful. During the night, George Harrison met Eric Clapton for the second time, the first being a brief encounter during the Another Beatles Christmas Show tenure in the 1964-1965 winter. The two guitarists became close friends in the following years. After the concert, John and George went clubbing with Brian Jones, Spencer Davis, Stevie Winwood, and Tom McGuinness. Finally, in 1969, George Harrison was at the Studio 3 in Abbey Road to complete Old Brown Shoe between 2:30 p.m. and 1 a.m. Under supervision of Chris Thomas, George recorded another lead guitar part and an organ part, erasing John Lennon's rhythm guitar work in the process. The session was then concluded by the mixing of the song in stereo. When this matter had been put to rest, George joined John Lennon in Studio 2 for a 1 to 4:30 a.m. session to record guitar overdubs on the I Want You, She's So Heavy rhythm track. The track had been recorded by the Beatles on the 23rd of February at the Trident Studios. Check out episode 54 of What A Fab Day for more info on that. The end result, reduced into what took the name of Take One, was mixed in stereo before the end of the session. And with this, we can conclude today's episode. Tomorrow, we'll witness the birth of Apple Corps, before it was called like that. Tune in for a better explanation. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.